Hello, my name's Jesse. I've been practicing magic now for about, I'd say, 12 years, and I'm only 17. The trick to this permanent trick is very simple. Sharpie really does have Sharpie written on both sides. Sorry, it's kind of hard to see. I'll see if I can zoom in on it a little bit. You should be able to see a little bit better, but it really is written on both sides. But this case, I've already taken the other Sharpie side off. This trick does take some preparing, but only one time. Then you can do the trick over and over again. If you wish, you can have two Sharpie markers in your pocket, or in your pocket bag, or whatever you want to call it. If you're a woman, your purse. So you can have a separate one to check before you do it, and you can do some sleight of hand and switch them so they can inspect it and see there really is two, whatever. But what you can do is, on one side of the Sharpie, just take a pair of scissors or acetone based nail polish and a cotton ball, and you can just rub it off, or a very fine grade sandpaper, rub it off. I prefer the acetone-based nail polish because it still leaves it smooth. It doesn't rough it up any like the scissors do or the sandpaper does. And you can't notice really that much difference. It stays smooth, so when they feel it, when you ask the spectator to feel it, it's still smooth and fine. I'm trying to get a close-up of it right here. You're rotating it like that, but quicker. That way it looks like it's staying in one, looks like it's on two different, like you're showing two different sides. So if you do it fast, but really, if you show two different sides, if we blink on one side, and it still has Sharpie on one side. So basically the performance would be, have regular Sharpie pen, says Sharpie on both sides, correct? Correct. And it doesn't rub off. You show the spectator, they can feel or whatever. It doesn't rub off or nothing. But you can simply just rub it off and it's gone, like that. And it's completely gone, unnoticeable to anybody. But you can just simply spin it around and it's back, and it's fine. All you're doing is just rotating it, and that's the simplest trick in the world. And they want you to pay money to figure this out. I think that's ridiculous. I don't know exactly how much it costs for you to find out the trick, but I'm pretty sure it's over $1, which is retarded for something you can do at home for free. If you wish to find more videos like this and instructional videos on any tricks that you can't find out how to do, or a trick you may have learned in your childhood, whatever, and it was a cool trick or something, or a trick, maybe even a little stupid trick that you like to do, just to entertain your friends or buddies, and you can't remember how to do it, leave me a comment and I'll make more videos. This is really my first magic tutorial video ever. I usually have videos on Rubik's Cubes and stuff, but magic is first. I love magic more than anything else. I've been doing it forever. But other than that, if you want to know how to do any tricks that you've seen on YouTube and you can't find out how to do it anywhere, and if I can't visually show you how to do it on the camera, I'll send you a message on how to do it in detail. It'll be easy, I guarantee it. Make the instructions so easy your son or daughter can do it at the age of 4. Thank you for watching. Please comment and rate.